Mikey Sherrill. Let's give it up. Let's give it up.
Senator Dick Cody served up a candidate for Congress to this crowd of breakfasting Democrats at the Florham Park Diner, all here to endorse Mikey Sherrill, who's running to unseat 12-term Republican Congressman Rodney Frelinghuysen. Cody talked about meeting Sherrill.
So when I met her, after about a half hour, I'm like, holy shit, she's good. I mean, I'm being honest with you, and my first impression was pretty good, because now she is the presumptive favorite in the primary and maybe to win the race.
Sherrill wields a fierce resume. Naval Academy graduate, Navy chopper pilot, assistant U.S. attorney, mom of four. She stepped up to run after seeing a wave of activism sweep across the district following Donald Trump's election. The Women's March on Washington, constituents picketing Frelinghuysen's office over his vote to repeal Obamacare and initial support for the tax reform bill. She says now is the time.
Is this the year of the woman in politics coming up?
Yes, it certainly feels that way. I think, you know, women have realized that they have a lot at stake and they really need a seat at the table to advocate for themselves. And so it does feel like there has just been a big upswelling of women who are getting engaged right now.
Frelinghuysen's never faced a serious re-election challenge. In fact, in seven election cycles, nobody ran against him in the Republican primary. But this time could be very different.
He has been there for a long time, and perhaps he's taking it for granted that he's going to be re-elected. But I sense an activism and a passion, especially among women voters, for a change.
More women are running for office. Sherrill's one of seven running for House seats in New Jersey in 2018. The Rutgers Eagleton Center for American Women in Politics has so far tallied 366 women across the nation running for House seats, most of them Democrats. It's about four times the number that ran 2 years ago.
They had a candidate forum a little while ago, and there were five or six candidates up there, two women, Mikey Sherrill and Tamara Harris, and they clearly won the day. And they were tapping into an energy about how could we let someone who did the Access Hollywood tape be our president. I think that there was a lot of sort of disbelief that actually happened, and a lot of anger and a lot of resolve to take it back in any way they can. And Frelinghuysen is certainly in the crosshairs of that.
Frelinghuysen spokesman Mike DeHame said in a statement, from serving in the Vietnam War to standing up to his own party to vote against the tax bill, he has never shied away from a tough decision or a tough fight. Mikey Sherrill clearly has the support of the wealthy Democrat elite of Washington, D.C. backing her, so we know this will be a well-funded, tough race. But we know Rodney's record of service and accomplishment will earn him the support of his constituents in North Jersey. But the ground is shifting. Cook's Political Report recently moved New Jersey's 11th district from leans Republican into the toss-up column. In Florham Park, I'm Brenda Flanagan, NJTV News.